Can we illuminate the road ahead by turning on the headlights of a car traveling at the speed of light? As far as we know, the speed of light is the highest speed in the universe, and no object can exceed it. But let's say we exceeded it and were inside a car traveling at speeds close to the speed of light, how would we see the road ahead? Of course, by turning on the headlights. And headlights are also light, therefore they travel at the speed of light. In such a situation, how would the light emitted from the headlights behave? The special theory of relativity, proposed by Albert Einstein in 1905, still holds valid today and explains how moving objects and light behave. The most important assumption of the theory is that the speed of light is the same for every observer. So how does this theory work for an observer inside a car moving at the speed of light? When we turn on the headlights of this car, does the light stay behind us or does it illuminate the road ahead? To answer this question, the first thing to understand is how the special theory of relativity works. While this question may initially seem like a paradox, once we understand the basic principles of the special theory of relativity, we realize that the answer is simple. According to the special theory of relativity, an observer inside any vehicle, regardless of its speed, will always perceive themselves as at rest or not moving as long as the vehicle is not accelerating. The second thing to realize is the phenomenon known as Doppler shift. When we move at this speed, time slows down for us, lengths become shorter, masses increase, and colors change. These effects are known as time dilation, length contraction, mass increase, and Doppler shift, respectively. All of these are consequences of the constancy of the speed of light for all observers, independent of their motions. Assuming you are in a car and you turn on the headlights, you will see that your headlights illuminate the road in front of you just like normal. This is because the light will be moving at the speed of light relative to you and will illuminate whatever is in front of you. However, if there is another car moving at the same speed in front of you, you will notice that your headlights do not illuminate that car. This is because both cars experience time dilation, and from your perspective, the clock in the other car will be ticking slower than yours. This means that the light reflected from the other car will take longer to reach your eyes compared to if both cars were at rest. What about if you're not in the car and standing by the side of the road? How would you see the car and its headlights? The answer is very different. First of all, you would see the car as very distorted and flattened due to its length contraction. It would also appear very heavy and slow due to its mass increase. Due to the Doppler shift, its color would shift towards the blue end of the spectrum. But what about the headlights? You would see them as very bright and narrow beams of high-energy radiation, like X-rays or gamma rays. This is because the light coming from the headlights would be shifted towards blue by a large factor due to the Doppler shift. Since the transverse components of light momentum don't change much compared to the longitudinal components, the beams would also be more focused along the direction of the car's motion. So to summarize, if you were inside a car moving at the speed of light and turned on your headlights, you would see the headlights working normally from your perspective. But they would appear very different to an observer outside the car. If you were an outside observer watching a car traveling at the speed of light with its headlights on, you would see them very differently than they actually are. Of course, all of this is hypothetical and practically impossible. No car or object with mass can ever reach the speed of light no matter how much energy you give it. Only massless particles like photons can move at this speed. But imagine what would happen if we could surpass this limit and explore the strange and wonderful world of relativity is both fun and educational. Hi everyone, I'm Samet Ozalp. Today we talked about a very interesting topic and I really enjoyed it. When it comes to Einstein and the theory of relativity, it always grabs our attention, doesn't it? I hope today's video was interesting and informative for you. Thank you for joining me on this journey. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and don't miss our new videos. See you soon.